Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome to some NHL 16 action. Yeah, I know I haven't brought a lot of NHL 16 yet this year, but I wanted to start a Be A Pro career. I started a Be A GM mode with the New York Rangers. I don't know. I haven't quite gotten to the point where I really have invested in it yet. Obviously, there have not been very many episodes so far. Really wasn't watched very well either, but, you know, I thought, hey, let's try a Be A Pro. Let's try to shake things up, do something differently, because I really do want to be playing NHL. I love this game. Not that I'm very good at it, but I do love to play it. So this was a way to do it. So I want to bring in one of my favorite players, now, probably my favorite player of all time, Russ Courtnall. Oh, man, I loved him back in the North Stars days. As a matter of fact, I have his game-worn jersey that looks just like that one right there in my closet, my holy grail. Game-worn jersey, Russ Courtnall, in all its glory, all hacked up with puck marks, stick marks, lots of stitches to repair the thing. Oh, yeah. Gotta love game-worn jerseys, right? Well, if you've ever collected them, yeah, the dirtier and grungier and more beat up, the better. Anyway, though, the last couple years of the North Stars were here before they were ripped away so rudely by Norm Green. I never forgive Norm Green for taking the team to Dallas. Ah, what a villain. What a villain in these parts, I tell you. But we got the Minnesota Wild eventually, and yeah, it's not quite the same, but obviously we've adopted that team and run with it. Hockey's back and all is good, but that really leaves a scar there from my teenage years. Losing the North Stars, but watching Russ Courtnall those last, I guess maybe he was only here the last season, but yeah, I don't know. He made a mark on me. He was definitely my favorite player back then. So we're going to roll with that. Now, back in Russ Courtnall's days, he played for Victoria, but it was the Victoria Cougars back then, I think they were called. So we're going to put him on the Victoria Royals for the very start of his career here before he gets drafted. And so we'll go ahead and set that up, put him here with the Victoria Royals, and we've got a series of things going on here that they'll show before we get into games. You see the hub here for Be A Pro, and instead of, it looks like, picking your own attributes that you will upgrade, now it kind of does it automatically. So we get the notification here. It's Memorial Cup time. Bring your A game. All right. So we're going to have a series of games, obviously, before we get drafted. This is your big chance to impress the NHL. Yes. Okay. Basically, we are putting on a show for the scouts. I have some advice for you. You can go ahead and read that. Basically, they want you to go out and be a plus five. Yeah. Okay. That sounds like a killer game there if you can do it. So the first game out was pretty much a disaster. We got blown out. I'm not going to bother showing that. There were really no stats to speak of for Courtnall in that game. So yeah, he gained some points. He looks like he regressed in some other stats there. Slap shot accuracy, wrist shot accuracy. Okay. Anyway, let's talk about what's next. Talking about the game coming up. We want to obviously do better than that. Get on the stat sheet here. At least get some assists and maybe the first goal. So we're going to kick off our on-ice action here for the very first time, hoping that Courtnall can get things going here. But they're already down 1-0 in the first. And here we go again in our own end. And, well, having problems even getting the puck away. Two quick goals here. And all of a sudden, it looks like we're going in the wrong direction yet again in this game. I don't know. Maybe we can get things going, but it's not looking good so far. So face-off coming up here in the attacking zone. Let's see if we can win this thing. Get one back. Courtnall gets it in the slot. Shoots and scores. There you go. The wrister and his very first goal. All right. That's what winning face-offs will do for you. We get on the board, and we're now down 2-1. Now, I found it interesting. I put in Russ Courtnall as a right wing, but it defaulted him as a left-handed shot. He was a right-handed shot. It's all right. We're going to go with it. I know. Not exactly perfect, but you know what? I'm more comfortable being a left-handed shot anyway. So, yeah, like I said, I'm going to roll with it. So there's the first goal for Courtnall, and gets the monkey off his back there as far as getting on the score sheet. So let's see if that ignites him and his teammates. So we got a 2-1 game with under 8 to play in the first. Another rush here. Russ calling for the puck. Now he's going to pass to a teammate who puts it 5-hole. And the goal, we're tied up. That's going to be an assist for Courtin on the goal with his goal now. And we got a 2-2 game. All right. Sharing the wealth right there. He is a playmaker after all. That's the style we went with. So he definitely wants to be dishing out assists. And he gets one right there. So Victoria storms back and ties this game, getting two straight goals right here. Hopefully they can continue their momentum. Now we're on the defensive end here, though. We don't want to give them another goal, but pass to the point. And, oh, no, that's picked off by Courtinall. Gets to turn this around, going the other way here. They got a rush, pass to a teammate. Going to fire this one. Oh, he makes the save. Got to reach back there, though. Didn't quite know where it was. Keeps it out of the net, however. So still 2-2, under 2 minutes left. Courtinall into the zone. He's going to turn back. Look for a teammate. Maybe come right out front. No, that's blocked. All right. Keep cycling here, though. That goes into the left corner. Working hard maybe to get the puck back. Okay. Still with possession. That one's on net. Nope. That one is blocked as well. Still working this around. Courtinall in front. Going to put it on net. And it ends up in the net. Who's going to get credit for that one? Give it to Courtinall, apparently. His second. I don't know. It wasn't tipped in front. I guess the goalie just had a big-time problem with this one. We'll have to go to the replay. Apparently, a teammate never redirected this in. Let's see. It's on the shoulder of the goalie. It ends up in the net. I guess all that was a result of Courtinall's shot. Very interesting there, but he now has two goals in the first period. All right. They got the 3-2 lead. We're into the second now. I usually play always up here as far as the orientation, but for some reason, we're going downward here as far as on the screen, attacking right at you in this period. Working hard and getting that one out front. It's a goal. They make it 4-2 now. Courtinall's not going to get the direct assist, but I think he's going to get one on here. Second assist. Let's look at how this plays out. Austin gets the goal. Yeah, Courtinall gets the second assist for his work in the corner right here. Would not give up the puck, and it eventually gets thrown out front. And Austin Carroll buries it, as you see from the net cam right there. So Victoria flying now, four straight goals, makes it 4-2. We're not done here, about halfway through the second. Rushing in, Courtinall going to peel back again, looking for teammates. Oh, pretty passing, Courtinall puts it in the net. It's a hat trick, right? No, it's waved off. What happened? Right there in the slot, perfect, but I think they're calling goaltender interference out front right there. Courtinall thinks he's got his hat trick. Oh, no, only to have it wiped out. What a great passing play they had going there, though. It's really unfortunate that they had to have it waved off, but I don't know. Maybe it doesn't go in the net if he wasn't interfered with. So still 4-2, and they are buzzing around the net again, and that's going to go in. Oh, it's 5-2 now. Who gets credit for this one? Is that Hicketts? Looks like the Captain Hicketts gets a goal. Is there an assist by Courtinall on this play? I don't think so, but he was in front, creating a screen a little bit. So 5-2 now, five straight goals, really, since being down in the 2-0 hole, have very much responded. That's a backhand chance for Courtinall, still looking for that hat trick. Oh man, they are just buzzing the net. Out front is Courtinall. He gets the puck, he scores. There it is, hat trick for Courtinall, not to be denied. He had it one time, it was waved off, and now this one is going to count as the Hats eventually fly down to the ice right there. There you go, young man. Getting the hat trick. Just very good work. Staying active. Getting out front where he could receive a pass. And he buries it. So Courtinall, three goals in this game. In a second here, I think we're going to see a recap of all three as a little highlight during the third period. So here you go. Here's the first one in the first period. Then you got the second one still in the first period. That one was kind of lucky, I guess. And then your last one to complete the hat trick. So it's 6-3 Victoria right now. Just 2 minutes left. Courtinall gets stripped of the puck right there, but they're still working on this. He gets the puck in front now and feeds a teammate, and why not? Gets another assist. Holy smokes. Three goals, three assists on the night. Have a game, Russ Courtinall. There you go. That's exactly what you got to do there if you're trying to impress the scouts. Tyler Soy gets the goal from the helper. Here you see Courtinall, a little hesitation, and then right over to his teammate, who puts it quickly in the net. So this is going to roll on to a Victoria victory. Didn't look like it early on, but then they just poured it on and win the game 7-3. Let's see what this plays out for stats and everything, because that was quite a game right there. Can't ask for much more from the kid than 3 goals and 3 assists, getting the hat trick. And the number one star also threw a couple hits in there for good measure. All right. Very good. Much better than the first game where he basically was kept off the score sheet. A little disappointing, but he bounces back in a big way right here. Team play, defense, I don't know. I thought the team play would have been a little higher than that. He gets 3 helpers along with his 3 goals, but maybe calling for the puck a little too much. I don't know. So we've gotten this thing kicked off. Come on back for more Russ Courtnall. Be a pro. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!